हेलो स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द सेकेंड चैप्टर फ्रॉम स्नैपशॉट बुक दैट इज़ द एड्रेस रिटन बाय मार्गा मेनको. सो इन माय अर्लियर वीडियो आई जस्ट एक्सप्लेन्ड यू व्हाट इज ऑल अबाउट इन द स्टोरी एंड आई जस्ट गिव यू अ वेरी शॉर्ट समरी एंड टोल्ड व्हाट इज देयर इन द स्टोरी. So I just told that the story is about a daughter who went to take the belonging of her mother at the place after a war. So here the author, she just belonged from Holland, Germany, and she just wrote the chapter because, as you know, that it's an autobiographical account, and its background is that Hitler sent some of the Nazi soldiers for concentration camps of Jews. So I already told you that what are concentration camps. It is basically where people are being tortured, right? So in short, I just want to tell you before I start with line to line explanation that in this chapter it starts when the mother of the author, she just told her to take all the belongings which she gave to Mrs. Darling before the war, right? So characters I have already told you in my previous video. So here we will start with the very first line. Do you still know me? I asked. So here the narrator, she is saying that, do you still know me? I asked. The women looked at me searchingly, and when she knocked the door at that time, the women, one woman, and who is that woman? She is Mrs. Darling. She just opened and she just started staring continuously. She had opened a door clink. Clink means a very narrow open. It means she haven't opened full door, narrow open. I came closer and stood on a step, and she was standing downstairs, and she just stood a single step and came more closer. No, I don't know you. I am Mrs. S's daughter. So Darling, Mrs. Darling, she said that, no, I don't know you. Even I didn't recognize who are you. So she tells that I am Mrs. S's daughter. She held her hand on the door as though she wanted to prevent it opening any further. So what she did, Mrs. Darling, she just hand her hand at the door as if she didn't want to open the door. Her face gave absolutely no sign of recognition, and her face was like she was in a guilt that the narrator knew it, but at this time her face was having no expression, means no sign of recognition also. She kept staring at me in silence, and she was staring the narrator in silence. This means that inside she was having some sort of guilt. Perhaps I was mistaken, and at that time narrator, she also didn't knew that whether she is in the right place or not. So maybe she thought for a while that maybe it was mistaken. I have came to another address, I thought. Perhaps it isn't her. So she thought that maybe it isn't her, means it's not Mrs. Darling. I had seen her only once, fleetingly. Fleetingly means in a very short time. So here the narrator, she is saying that I just have seen her just once in a very short time. That was years ago, means I just met Darling, Mrs. Darling, years ago, and it was of very short span of time. It was most probable that I had rung the wrong bell. So here the narrator, she is thinking that maybe I am at the wrong place. The woman let go of the door and stepped to the side. So woman, she just closed the door and she just stepped aside. She was wearing, here the woman let go of the door and stepped to the side. So here she didn't came forward, but she just stepped aside. So when she just stepped aside, at that moment the narrator, she just saw and she got to know that she was wearing her mother's green knitted cardigan. So she was wearing handmade cardigan, means sweater, green knitted cardigan. The wooden buttons were rather pale from washing. So here the narrator, she just saw that cardigan very closely, and she is saying that the wooden button which is attached in the cardigan was turned yellow just because of regular washing. She saw that I was looking at the cardigan and half hid herself again behind the door. And at that time, Mrs. Darling, that lady, she just get to know that the girl which is standing in front of me is having a very close looking at the cardigan. And by this, she just hid herself again the door. But I knew now that I was right. And by this activity, by this behavior of Mrs. Darling, the narrator, she just got to know, and she was very confident at this moment of time that she was standing in the right place. "Well, you knew my mother?" I asked. And she just asked question from that lady that, "Do you knew my mother?" "Have you come back?" said the woman. I thought that no one had come back, and at this question of narrator, that lady, she just asked that, "You came back?" said the woman. I thought no one had came back. So here the narrator didn't understand what she is saying, to whom she is saying. And at this time, she was thinking, narrator, that no one had come back, only me, means only I am here, no else was there. So actually, she was asking for her mother. But at this moment of time, only narrator was there in front of that lady, Mrs. Darling. No one else was there, only me.